Hey guys, Miniature77 here, and today I'm going to teach you how to trade Pokemon using the VisualBoyAdvance emulator. Now I'm actually using the newest version, the VisualBoyAdvance M, I think that's what they're calling it now. But yeah, that's not important, not really anyways. But in order to trade, it depends on what Pokemon game you're playing. For example, in Pokemon Fire Red and Leaf Green, you can only trade with the Hoenn games if you collect both crystals in the Sevi Islands. But yeah, Pokemon Emerald, Ruby, and Sapphire, they can trade A-okay. But yeah, in order to actually trade, what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna want to go to the Pokemon Center, and then to the second floor using the fancy escalator over there. And yeah, you're going to go all the way to the right. Unless you're playing Pokemon Ruby and Sapphire, then you want to go to the second or the center person. And yeah, so once you're facing the very last person, you're going to want to go into options. And oh, no, my bad. I forgot a setting. I'm going to go into the emulation, and we're going to click off pause when inactive. Just so this way the games are running at the exact same time in the background. And what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna finally go to link, make sure that's cable, and we're going to click start network link. And on one game, we're going to click server, right? And while this is running over here, we're going to click the same thing, but we're gonna be the client. And you can see all players connected, all players joined. We're just gonna talk to this person. And unless you're battling, and since we're trading, we're just gonna click the trade center and save the game. Alright, so please wait. When all players are ready, press A. Start link with two players. And that's about it. Now you can trade Pokemon. Just gonna go up over here. But yeah, unlike Melon DS, where it's a bit like speed up sensitive, like you have to speed up the game in order to transfer Pokemon. This you can speed up whenever you want. Might lag the game a bit, but it's all good. And I'm gonna trade Pokemon to show you that it actually works. You might get a communication error if you like click off the window and like do something else, because it just needs to be running. And I would really recommend clicking out of this while it's trading. It's pretty cool to see this old animation. I'm not even sure if this is a fair trade or not. But yeah, we're gonna speed it up. And saving. But yeah, you can actually trade and check the summary of your Pokemon. Okay, so here, let's check out the other person's Pokemon. Look at that. Pretty cool. Anyways, I'm getting off topic here. That's not really important. But you want to exit. Just let both games go over here. Link will be terminated if you leave the room. Is that okay? And for some reason, Emerald kind of takes a long time doing this. Then it'll save your game and update your trainer card. And that is how you trade Pokemon using the VisualBoyAdvance emulator. One thing I also do want to mention is by using this special link feature, you're actually able to do other like connectivity features. Like do this, the berry blender, I think. And I think for like Ruby and Sapphire, there's something about connecting to each other's secret bases. But yeah, this just basically shows you just if you want to do something else other than trading Pokemon, you can do it.